Having my brother in it together.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Uptown Charlotte and rain-soaked Bank of America Stadium. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25.
It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
They go play action with Jackson. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Jeremy Chin picks it off. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy
away. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off, and the Ravens are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
And that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
On first and 10, it's Dobbins. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. From the gun, it's Jackson. It's complete to Brown, right side.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding it for a short game.
He'll swing this out to Dobbins. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
On first down, Dobbins stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate through the line of scrimmage.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 13-yard line. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. He'll check this down to Dobbins out of the backfield. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. But keep in mind, if you're thinking of staying on the ground, this is a top 5 rush defense.
Yeah, but I don't think you shy away totally with the run. At least show them the hint of a run before you decide to throw the football.
Buying time to his left. Boy, he almost did that himself, but it looks like he's about a foot or two short. Decent gain on the scramble to 6, but now it's 4th.
That was a good effort there, trying to do it on his own, but as a defender, you're in a tough spot because you have coverage responsibilities behind you, and if you take off too quick to try and get him down, he might loft it over your head.
So better to track with your man defensively than try to go up and make a stop on the quarterback.
Exactly right. What you're hoping is that your guys in the front 7 can get him down.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches. They're going for it with Dobbins. And he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And that will force a turnover on downs. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, 1 play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a 1-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. This is McCaffrey on the give. And he gets this up just shy of the 15. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. This ball nearly intercepted. A once-in-a-season chance for the big fella, but he couldn't corral it. 4th down, straight ahead. Jack Fox out to punt here on 4th down. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They'll throw on 1st down with Jackson. Dancing to his left. And he's got his receiver. That's Sammy Watkins. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. So 1 play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Dobbins running out of the gun. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.